Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to see a Sri Lankan delicacy which goes by the name Kaliya. It has two versions, one veg and one non-veg. The veg version is simply frying three different kinds of vegetables in oil and then cooking it in coconut milk. The non-veg version is simply adding one non-veg ingredient, preferably mutton liver cubes to it. The veg and the non-veg version taste almost similar, but if you are a non-veg lover, you will really enjoy having a non-veg ingredient in this particular dish. So let's get into the recipe now. Take two raw bananas, 5 brinjals and 3 potatoes, cinnamon stick, cardamom, cloves and bay leaf, some curry leaves, about 5 onions thinly sliced, 4 tomatoes roughly chopped, about 3 green chilies slit, 3 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste, 2 cups of thin coconut milk, and 5 to 6 tablespoons of thick coconut milk and 250 grams of mutton liver cubes. You can substitute this with paneer cubes. Now we have all the ingredients ready, so let's start with the marination. To the liver cubes I have already added a pinch of turmeric powder, pepper powder and salt. Cut the raw banana into cubes, add 1/4 teaspoon salt, turmeric powder and chili powder and mix it well. We are going to do the same to the potatoes and brinjals. Cut the potatoes into cubes and add 1/4 teaspoon salt, turmeric powder and chili powder and mix it well. And then cut the brinjal into cubes, add 1/4 teaspoon salt, turmeric powder, chili powder. Mix it well. Keep all these aside for 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, it will leave out some water. So drain the water and keep it ready for the cooking process. Now all our ingredients are marinated and ready. Let's start cooking. In a pan, add sufficient oil for frying. I have added about 250 ml of oil. When oil turns hot, add the marinated raw banana into it. It is important to fry raw banana first, potato second, brinjals third, and then the liver cubes or paneer. If you fry brinjals first, the seeds of the brinjal will spread into the oil and will blacken as you fry the other vegetables. If you follow this order, your oil will be clean till the end and your vegetables will also retain their individual flavors. Stir the raw banana occasionally in the oil so that it gets fried evenly. Raw banana usually takes about 4 to 5 minutes to get fried. That will be the perfect time to remove it from the oil. Now we can see that it is fried evenly on all sides, so I am removing it from the oil and putting it on a plate. You can even taste one of the pieces to check if it is cooked well. Now in the same oil, we are going to add the marinated potato cubes. Potatoes will take about 3 to 4 minutes to get fried. So keep stirring occasionally in the oil and then once it is fried, we'll remove it from the oil. In the same oil, add the marinated brinjal cubes. Brinjal gets fried in 2 to 3 minutes, so monitor them carefully and remove it from the oil before it turns too dark. In the same oil, add the marinated liver cubes. You can substitute this with paneer cubes. This will not affect the taste of the dish in any way and you can still achieve a very good taste. Both the liver cubes and the paneer cubes fries in 2 to 3 minutes, so you can remove them once they are perfectly cooked. We are not undercooking any of the vegetable here, so if you feel the vegetable is not perfectly cooked, you can increase the frying time. All our major ingredients are fried and kept ready for the next step. Take another hard-bottomed vessel and add about 8 to 9 tablespoons of the same oil that we used for frying. Now add the bay leaf, cinnamon stick, cardamoms and cloves into the oil. Once the spices start to release their aroma, add the green chilies into it. Now add the chopped onions. We do not want the onions to turn brown, we only want it to be translucent. So keep the flame in medium and fry the onions patiently. Now add curry leaves and chopped tomatoes. Once the tomatoes turn mushy, add 3 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste. Keep the ginger garlic paste in the center of the vessel and allow it to get fried for about 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, you can mix it with the other ingredients. This method allows the ginger garlic paste to get cooked completely, to spread evenly, and it does not leave any raw smell in the final dish. After 2 minutes, add salt, add 1 teaspoon chili powder, 2 teaspoons dhania powder and 1/4 teaspoon cumin powder, which is optional. Give it a good mix and allow it to cook for 3 to 4 minutes. Once we see the oil separating, we can add the fried vegetables into the vessel. Now add the vegetables one by one. Vegetables slowly and carefully so that the masala coats all of the vegetable cubes. Put 2 glasses of thin coconut milk on the vegetables and mix it well. This thin coconut milk is the second extract from the coconut. As we keep mixing, we can see that the curry is thickening and is getting absorbed completely. Curry has thickened, add about 5 to 6 tablespoons of thick coconut milk on top. This coconut milk is the first extract from the coconut and should be really thick. Now switch off the flame, give it a gentle mix and allow it to rest for 15 to 20 minutes. After 15 minutes, our coconut milk would have settled down and our dish will be perfectly ready. You can serve this with a variety of main courses such as ghee rice, coconut rice, paratha, string hoppers, chapatis and many more. Please try it out and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye-bye.